Coach, what can you tell us about tonight's lineup?
There's some guys nicked up. No one's going to skate today, so we'll know more after warm-up tonight.
Good chance Derek Rossard slides back in?
Yeah. We'll, like I said, there's some guys nicked up, so we're the, you know, at this point we have one extra D and one extra forward, so that decision will be made for us.
Can you share with us who's nicked up?
No. It's upper body, though, whoever it is.
Do you anticipate Jacob Bernard-Docker playing tonight?
It all obviously it depends on that situation on the back, whether he'll go in or not. And, you know, one of the things with him is, you know, when he does go in, if he goes in, is we want him to have a long run at it, and not a guy that's going to be up, down, up, down. His development is at the utmost of importance.
Been given on him in the AHL this year?
He's played really well, been their best defenseman, progressing exactly the way he should be. You know, and at some point, you know, he will make that jump where he's going to be a full-time guy. It's just a matter of when.
What was your view on him in training camp? Did he taper a little at the end?
Yeah, I think that's fair to say and it gets hard. I mean, you play in a lot of games. The other team starts to put in their top guys. And that's all part of it. You know, it's, you know, you look at guys like Brandstrom and you look at some of these D that have been in the league a long time. It takes a while before you can do it every single night. You know, you can do it for a game or two, and then you get the odd guy that's special, like the Sandersons, that come right out and do it. But it takes a long time before you can, you know, handle the other team's top guys and keep your confidence, because that's the biggest thing is being able to have confidence while you do it.
How have you seen Brady Tkachuk's offensive game grow from when he was a rookie to where he is now? Because I think a lot of us thought that, you know, when he came in, that maybe there was a bit of a ceiling on his offensive game, and it looks like he's opened up 30 goals last year and 15 points.
Skating has improved. You know, I joke with him, and you know, his first year he was falling, and he was, you know, he's gotten so much stronger. His skating's gotten better, and then. I think he's always had that offensive touch and that offensive creativity. I just think as his skating has gotten better, he's been able to beat guys wide. He's able to get under at the net more. Obviously, he's a presence, and guys don't want to play him quite as hard as other guys. He gets a little more room, and he's willing to take it to the cage, too, and score ugly. So what he's showing right now is that he can score from distance, you know, cute plays, but he also can crash and bang and score ugly ones. And that's – if you're going to score 30 and 40 and 50, a lot of them are coming from the blue paint, and that's where he goes.
If you remember his first year, second year, like he was getting like close to like 300 shots a year. Like, have you noticed a difference in like the, I guess, the volume of his shots or like the
probably the quality of his shots? You know, yeah. I think, you know, it's not a bad thing to shoot and shoot from everywhere. I mean, you look at how many guys would even throw that on net, the one Drew threw on net last game, and they just go in sometimes. But yeah, I agree. I think Brady's. He's shooting, but he's also shooting from good areas. He's, you know, moving the puck when he has to. He's wearing the other team down. Then when he does get his chance, it's either on a quick up or the other team's kind of worn down.
Also, I'd like to ask you about Alex DeBrincat, because I think, you know, you look at him and he's a 40-goal scorer two times off to, like, statistically off to a slow start, but when you look at the underlying numbers, they're all good. So as a coaching staff, when you look at those, the shots and the all that, are you feeling like, okay, at some point here the dam is going to burst for Alex DeBrincat?
For sure it is. He's a career, I believe, 16% shooter. He's shooting at just over 4%. So, I mean, if it was his first year, you wouldn't know. But stats tend to always go back to the numbers. And it says that, you know, whether it's the month of November or the month of December, you know, he's probably going to have a month where it goes in at a 25% rate, and he'll get right back to his number. So, you know, he's getting 6-7 shots, grade A chances. He had 2 or 3 grade A's in the first period last game that haven't gone in. And I think some, you know, maybe he gets a weak one and all of a sudden, he, you know, it starts to go for him. But what he can't do is stop shooting. Just keep shooting, do what you do.
DJ, a big night for Claude Giroux, obviously. Has he given you any element that you didn't have at your disposal the past few years?
Face-offs, clearly. Our face-offs were in the top 10 in the league, I believe. They're close to it. We were in the top 5 till the last little bit here, which is helping us with the puck. You know, leadership. But the biggest thing is for me is that he's still a student of the game and he wants to be pushed. He doesn't want to be the, you know, and I'm pushing him, but, you know, I think he's at the point where, you know, you're a veteran player, and I think sometimes the coaches just tend to leave the guy and let him do his thing. I've pushed him really hard here, especially of late, and he's been appreciative of it. You know, and really, I think he's coachable. He's been really coachable for me.
There's not that many people in the league who have played for a team for so long and then play against them. How? What are you sensing he's feeling today?
You know, he looked pretty relaxed this morning. He's got the room in there. They put all the office on. Seems like it's on every time I go for a coffee. So he was catching his third episode of The Office this morning. So I don't know. He looked pretty calm to me. We're not going to skate. So, you know, it's obviously it's going to be different for him. You know, 1,000 games in one place is, you know, your heart's clearly been with that organization. But, you know, his heart's here now, and we'll see how it goes tonight for him.
Do you throw him over the boards a couple extra times just because you might sense that he's really rearing to go?
Well, I did last game because he was playing, and he was playing the right way, and he was playing hard, and he was playing to win. And if he does that, I'll just keep throwing him over the boards.